Hello. Sitting here at the beach. You. The beach is covered with crabs, lights, chickens, and probably see maybe the masses of them here. Even that's all, you know, 3 inches deep at the high tide line of crabs' legs. And I just sat here to listen to the water. Maybe I'll see if I can get rid of the view, which of course means it'll be harder to hear me as I flip the camera that way. But I'm going to try anyway. Balance you on the seashell here. I think that might kind of work a little bit. Hoping that by doing that, we'll see the water a little. Let's see if it's leaning on my foot, so my foot might slip in the wet sand. I was just kind of noticing how these waves are slow and easy and gentle. Have a little motherly sense to them. I can imagine that the most tentative being, some being that's most tentative about going in the water, and you know, the fears that they surround with that, they might be convinced to step in here. And I'm just kind of thinking how, you know, each wave represents a change, you know. Don't know if you're able to see that flock of birds flying over the water, but seemingly an inch off the water surface. And that was pretty cool. And so each wave is, you know, a state change in the energies. Kind of represents that, but the wave is this pattern that you notice and name. But it doesn't stop being the ocean when it's the wave. It's easy to see it return to the ocean when the wave is over, but it never stopped being the ocean. And you have to think of change as, you know, sort of binary, and, you know, the tipping point, you know, when one thing becomes another, to invest up some fear, quite often. But the types of waves here really call to mind a real easiness to the change, a real gentleness. It would be nice to do a little meditation with the waves, with the change. The challenge of change being at the moment one of its least challenging iterations. So I'm trying to just sit here and meditate, tune into the waves, not necessarily their sound or their rhythm, but it could be. It could be their look. I don't know how well you're able to see them on the camera. I'm just kind of tune into the fact of the waves and how they seem to be their own thing. But they've never stopped being their mother. And how that seeming change of state can be this gentle. I can notice the same thing in my breath, and one way to do this is to really challenge your breath by making it exceedingly deep or exceedingly long, or, you know, on the either exhale or inhale. So when you get to that moment of change where you just have to inhale or you just have to exhale, see if you can seek the ease of that change, the gentleness of that change, the motherliness of that change. So you're welcome to do that with the breathing if you like. It doesn't have to be the most challenged breath, but challenge a little bit more than you ordinarily might, where you're invited to have a difficult change, but setting yourself up to reference a gentle change. Today I'm sitting a couple, let's say, two-thirds of a meter from the edge of the water that's really doing this great job of reminding me of the quietude of change, the gentle possibility of the switcheroo. And while I'll endeavor to embark upon a challenging moment of breath, I'm facing very near this insistent reminder. Thank you.